Hello everyone, 大家好. Today we will be exploring an important Chinese character, 很, which means very in English. We will also compare 很 and 非常. While both can translate to very in English, there is a key difference between them. By the end of this lesson, we hope that you will have a clear understanding of when to use 很 and when to use 非常. Let's get started. The Chinese character 很 means very in English and is made up of two parts. The left part is 去, which is also the radical. The radical 去 is commonly known as 双人旁. Chinese characters with the radical 去 are related to walking or roads. It has the meaning of walking slowly and the appearance of walking and stopping. The right part is 梗, which means blunt, tough, or chewy. 很 is a pictophonetic word. 梗 indicates the sound and 去 conveys the meaning. Number 1, 很 has the meaning of high level or degree of something when used with an adjective. 小明是个很聪明的孩子. 小明 is a very clever child. 他住在很远的地方. He lives in a faraway place. Number 2, use 很 plus adjectives to modify nouns. When using this sentence structure, 的 is normally added. However, when using 很多, 的 is not added. 他不会游泳, 所以不敢去水很深的地方. He can't swim, so he doesn't dare to go places where the water is very deep. 他喜欢在大热天喝很冷的水. He likes to drink very cold water on extremely hot days. 他讨厌去很多人的地方. It is wrong to add 的 before 人. You do not say 他讨厌去很多的人的地方. He hates going to crowded places. 他家里有很多问题. There are many problems in his family. You do not say 他家里有很多的问题. You do not add 的 after 很多. Number 3, add 很 in front of single syllable adjectives. 他食欲不好,最近吃得很少. His appetite is poor, and he has been eating very little recently. 彼得的房间 很大. Peter's room is very big. If we say 彼得的房间大, it means that someone else's room is small. Number 4, use 很 in front of auxiliary verbs or verb phrase to mean high level or degree of something. Auxiliary verbs such as 应该, 可能, 愿意, can be modified by 很 alone. For example, 这很应该, this is reasonable. 他很愿意, he is very willing. The following auxiliary verbs must be formed into a verb phrase before it can be modified by 很. For example, 彼得很会吃. When using the auxiliary verb 会 with 很, you need to add a verb after 会 to form a verb phrase. It is wrong to say 彼得很会。You have to say 彼得很会 something. 很会吃，很会写，很会唱。小明很能吃苦。小明 is able to endure hardships. Number 5, use 很 in front of adjectives that express attitude, understanding, evaluation, state, and emotion. 彼得很用功地在工作。Peter works very hard. 他是个很负责任的人。He is a very responsible person. 家人都很支持他的决定。His family fully supports his decision. Number 6. Use 很 in a verb object phrase. Some verbs cannot be modified by 很 if used alone. However, when a verb has an object to form a verb object phrase, 很 can be used. For example, 你说的话很伤我的心。What you said really hurts my feelings. The sentence sounds odd if we were to say 你说的话很伤心。An object in this case is 我 must be added in the sentence to sound more natural. Let's take a look at another example. 彼得对画画很感兴趣。Peter is very interested in painting. You cannot simply say 画画很感兴趣。You must explain who is interested in drawings or painting. So the object is 彼得。彼得对画画很感兴趣。Number 7, using 很 plus 的 or 不。When using 很 plus 的 or 不, it only applies to verb phrases that express attitude, evaluation, feelings, and mood. For example, 老板很看得起彼得。The boss thinks highly of Peter. 他是个很靠不住的人。He is an unreliable person. 他和任何人都很谈不来。He doesn't get along with anyone. Number 8. Using 很 with 不 something. Let's take a look at some sentence examples using this structure 很 plus 不 something. 你可以考虑彼得，他是个很不错的人。You can consider Peter. He is a very good person. 很不错的人。这个问题看来很不简单。This problem seems to be quite complicated. Please take note that 很不 and 不很 are not the same. Let's compare. 他的身体很好。Let's compare it to 他的身体不很好。The first sentence means he is healthy. The second sentence means he is not so healthy. Number 9, use 很 after 的 to express a high level or degree. For example, 菜市场热闹得很。The market is very lively. 电影院人多得很。The cinema is very crowded. 你做的菜好吃得很。The food you made is very delicious. Now let us compare 很 and 非常。The Chinese word 很 and 非常 have the same meaning, and sometimes they can be used interchangeably. 非常 is made up of two Chinese characters, 非 and 常。非 by itself means not or wrong, and 常 means always. So when is 很 and 非常 used differently? Number one, 非常 cannot be used as a degree complement. For example, let's use the previous sentence example. 菜市场热闹得很。It is wrong to replace 很 to 非常。You cannot say 菜市场热闹的非常。But in written form, you can write 菜市场热闹非常 without 的。Number two, 非常 can be combined directly with a noun, but not 很。Sentence example, 现在是非常时期，你不要来打扰他。It is a very critical time now. Don't disturb him. It is wrong to replace 非常 to 很。You cannot say 现在是很时期，你不要来打扰他。这里刚发生了非常事件。An unusual event just happened here. Just like the first sentence, you cannot change 非常事件读很事件。Number three, you cannot use 不 in front of 非常。For example,他的汉语讲得不很好。You cannot say, 他的汉语讲得不非常好。This is wrong. 玛丽不很了解彼得。Mary doesn't really know Peter well. Just like the first sentence, you cannot say, 玛丽不非常了解彼得。However, you can say 玛丽非常不了解彼得。But this sentence, the nuance is different from 玛丽不很了解彼得。When you say 玛丽非常不了解彼得 means Mary really does not know Peter well. Number four, 非常 can be duplicated.You can say 他非常非常爱你, but you cannot say 他很很爱你. If you want to duplicate 很, you must say 他很爱很爱你. What about this sentence? 小明考试得满分, 妈妈非常非常高兴. Can you change 非常非常高兴?读很很高兴。Of course not. You cannot say 小明考试得满分，妈妈很很高兴。This is wrong. Thanks for tuning in. Did you enjoy learning about 很 and 非常 today? If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends.Subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell so you won't miss out on any of our videos. See you! 再见!